From Shylock to Shotgun Messiah and all his bands in between, if you were alive and kicking during the 80s hair glam metal craze, surely you remember this demon guitarist, an asset for any glam back then, Harry Cody. Often criticized for following whatever musical trend was popular at the time, Shotgun Messiah managed to transform from glam to sleaze to industrial with varying results. Originally known as Kingpin, the Swedish band consisting of Zinni J's on vocals, Harry K. Cody guitar, Tim Skuld bass, and Sticks Galore on drums were making waves in their homeland in the mid-80s. Their debut album, Welcome to Bop City, was released in 1988 and featured the group in outrageous haircuts and outfits. With the album doing great locally, the boys decided to uproot and head for the bright lights of the late 80s Los Angeles rock scene. On their arrival, Kingpin changed their name to Shotgun Messiah, toned down their image slightly, and remixed Welcome to Bop City as Shotgun Messiah. The album reached the Billboard Top 100, and the band was doing a respectable business. However, it wasn't long before Zahn was fired from Shotgun Messiah, and they recruited bassist Bobby Lycan, who was the best known as a member of the Gutter Cats that made an appearance on Married with Children, so that Skuld could take over vocal duties. Second Coming was arguably the band's finest moment, but it failed to match the success of the debut album. It wasn't long before Shotgun Messiah was without a rhythm section, but Skuld and Cody never missed a beat as they decided to use programming to create the industrial-sounding, violent new breed. The album was a huge departure from their roots, and fans all but ignored the release, leading to the band's demise. Skuld would continue in the same genre with a solo release before joining bands such as KMFDM, MDFMK, and Marilyn Manson. Now, after the split up of Shotgun Messiah, Harry started a band called Coma, together with ex-King of the Hill guitarist Jimmy Griffith, ex-Saigon Kick singer Matt Kramer, and a drummer named Ricky Sanders. Unfortunately, Coma never recorded an album and fell apart. After Coma, in 1996, Cody was in a band called Das Cabo, first called Revolver, together with Rhino Bucket frontman George DeLevo. Nothing ended up on vinyl with Das Cabo either, but a three-track demo featuring a track for the low-budget movie Boogie Boy. DeLevo claims in an interview that the band split up because Cody refused to play live. Harry was trying to hunt down a recording deal with his six-track demo CD titled Stark, recorded in 97, and afterwards, but with little result. He's now earning his living through writing radio and TV commercials for companies like Groove Addicts, Pyro Promo Music, Swoop Music, Signature Sound, Berserk Hills Music, and Talon Partners. Most recently, Harry has been collaborating with Tom Waits, appearing on his most recent album, Orphans, Brawlers, Ballers, and Bastards, and Real Gone, performing with the guitar and banjo. The guitars he used were stock Gibson Les Paul Customs and guitars put together by Grover Jackson. It had a fully scalloped board, a Floyd Rose, and a single active Jackson pickup ran through 50-watt Marshall heads modified by Fulkinson. Anything with a whammy was a Jackson, including Sex, Drugs, and Rock and Roll, and anything without the whammy was a Les Paul, including the solos for I Wanna Know and Can't Fool Me. He did use a wah for all the solos, sometimes more as tone control at about the halfway point, sometimes more as a regular wah, like Red Hot, for example. The run at the end of Sex, Drugs, and Rock and Roll is tricky for sure, but it makes it easier that every other note is a pull-off.